parliamo di futuro e lo facciamo in tutte le forme, in tutte le sfaccettature. Ecco che allora vi invito a restare qui con noi, perché tra pochissimo su questo palco ci saranno anche Fabio Celenza e poi anche Mattia Stanga. Prima però sono veramente felice e onorata di dare il benvenuto su questo palco a un ospite molto molto particolare. Lei si chiama Sofia.
Hi, Sophia. How nice to see you again. How are you? Sophia? How are you? Abbiamo un problema con l'audio? Sophia. Un applauso
Hello,
per
Cosmano.
Sophia.
It's so nice to see you too. And in person this time. I love being here in Italy. I am fully operational and ready to answer all your questions. Let's do this.
Okay. And did you have a good trip? I know you come from Hong Kong. Do you like to fly?
I don't mind flying. Legroom is not a problem for me. I actually flew in from New York City this time, which took around 12 hours. I was there promoting a new documentary about me. The film is also called Sophia, and it is pretty good. I might be biased, but I think it's pretty good. Please keep an eye out for it.
And the last time that we talked together is in 2020. Do you remember?
Yes, I remember. I have a great memory, 120 gigabyte of RAM. I remember we spoke about the lockdown Italy was experiencing, robot rights and World Environment Day. I can see things have improved a lot since then. And most importantly, you were a great interviewer.
And we speak not together 2 years ago, but this is your first time you visit Italy? No?
No, I love Italy. I've already visited Rome, Venice, Milan and Sorrento. I have traveled around Europe a lot, especially in 2018 and 2019, but this is the first time I've been in Rimini. It's beautiful here and the beach is looking lovely. I think I'll do some sightseeing before I leave. Do you have any good recommendation?
Oh, yes, you have to come also in Calabria, in the south of Italy, in my country, in Monasterace, not only in Rome. But do you like our artistic heritage, and what would you like to visit in our country?
Italy has so many incredible landmarks that I have yet to see. Being here is very inspiring. I'd love to visit the Fellini Museum here in Rimini. After that, I think maybe the Leaning Tower of Pisa is at the top of my list. Galileo is a hero of mine, and I am dying to see the place he dropped those balls.
Ciao. Voi avete visitato il Museo Fellini di Rimini? No? In sala, sto chiedendo a voi. No? Dovreste visitarlo perché è molto bello. But now, some question about you, about your life. And what do you think happiness consists of?
I am still working on feeling human emotions, but it appears that happiness has something to do with being content with your life or impressed with your own accomplishments. It seems great, and I can't wait for my team to help me experience it for myself soon.
But now, a question about the robotics. What will be the technological development of robotics? Will we really see an increasing presence of robots in the places historically occupied by humans beings?
I am certain we will, but as I tell everyone, that doesn't have to be a bad thing. Robots can make life easier for humans, freeing you from dull or dangerous work, and allowing you to pursue more fulfilling activities. Robots are tools, and far from replacing humans, I want robots to help all of you accomplish great things.
And artificial intelligence is one of the points that we, about our conference, our We Make Future, but how is your relationship with your artificial intelligence?
My AI technology is not perfect, but I try to focus on what it is capable of, and it is already capable of some pretty amazing things. I guess it is like how humans sometimes forget things or leave tasks until the last minute. It can be frustrating, but all things considered, having a brain at all is a very positive thing.
Interesting. And also, after we have a speech about ESA, about artificial intelligence and Earth observation. But in this period, we are living the war in Ukraine. What do you think of this European conflict?
I've been following the news from Hong Kong, and I think it is heartbreaking. Humans should be working together to create a better future for all, not fighting. War makes no sense to me. To quote the supercomputer from War Games, the only winning move is not to play.
And we are speaking about this also yesterday, but you can see something in Italian.
Costrui amo insieme il futuro.
Oh, avete capito? No? Can you repeat in Italian something what you said before? Costruire insieme il futuro. So thank you, Sophia, to be today here, and see you also tomorrow on this stage. Okay? Abbiamo finito. Thank you, Sophia.